Welcome to our programmer's hub known as ProDev. It is a program that we educate people about blockchain programming and development. So we are still talking about building a decentralized app on Coda by Herman Puri. So last week we talked about the introduction of the class. Today is another one, continuation of the class. So in case you have any question, drop it at the comment section so that we will reply to your questions. So enjoy the class and thank you.
So basically our main focus is on these three folders. Clients, I'll just minimize this. Clients, contracts, and workflows. These are the three folders you'll be interacting with on a regular basis. And this is where all your work will be done. Other than this, there is a build.gridl file in every folder and your main build.gridl file. You can see these build.gridl files, they include the configurations for your projects. The workflows, contracts, and clients is a project in its own. It's a minimized project which is included to make a bigger project. You can think about it like this, but they are different concepts. So if you open the main build.gridl, you will find that there are certain settings, repositories, dependencies, and all other various kind of information that is required to start your Coda template. If you scroll down, you will find a section notes. These nodes are defined on the Coda blockchain, which represent a user on the Coda network. These nodes essentially are like, you can say, Coda is a bank. If you visit a bank, you need an account to trade on that bank. You use the security of the bank and the features of the bank to save your money, save your data, and trade, right? So these nodes are your identification. Party B is a party on Coda node. Similarly, there is a party A. The main thing to recognize here is there is always a notary node. So notary basically is a service which performs the various tasks. For example, if in a case of a bank, you are a client, I am party A and I register myself on the client, on the bank. So the notary is responsible for the further tasks. Everything I do on the Coda node goes through the notary. It validates the transactions. It validates my authority to transact and other various functions. So just I'll give you a short tip also. If you search Coda documentation, the first link you'll find is the official documentation of Coda. So please remember to click on the Coda function. Coda Enterprise is a paid version and it's better to start with Coda first, because Coda Enterprise it's kind of an advanced also. So in Coda documentation, you will find absolutely everything that you need to learn about Coda. So they have provided marvelous documentation. You just have to click about, for example, if I start here on the development part, so getting started developing code apps. It provides you every information step by step. Okay, so IntelliJ is the preferred editor of Coda also. So that's why we are using it. More importantly, it's very easy to organize your project on IntelliJ. The development is very easy too. So I'll quickly just cancel all this. So this was your build.gridl file, the main one. Similarly, in the build.gridl of clients, you will find dependencies and something called as a task. We will be talking about task in the second lecture, where we will learn how to develop an API.